Hello and welcome. Yes, it's me, HJP Designs, and today I will be reviewing the Doctor Who trailer. Yes, it is a bit of a late upload, I know, but I couldn't hold it in anymore, and I just wanted to talk about it. It was action-packed. It had two people who have been in Doctor Who, Jack and the American bloke from the Arachnids in the UK, and it just looks fantastic for Christmas. And I've picked some photos or pictures to go along with this. So here we go. We've got Ryan, Yaz and Graham in a house, and I think by the looks of it that could be Graham and Ryan's house. Now, it has been confirmed that Graham and Ryan are leaving, so what will happen to them I don't really know. Judging by this next picture, the lady in the red coat is an actress called Harriet Walton. Now, she was in Call the Midwife, but judging by another photo which we will look at a bit later on, I think she might be the Prime Minister of the UK. So what is she up to? Is she going to be another Harriet Jones, or is she going to be a bit different? Maybe an eviler version of the Prime Minister. So in this picture is the guy from Arachnids of the UK, the guy who was like, yeah, well, these spiders, he was like, killed that spider, didn't he? I didn't really like him that much, so he's back in this Christmas. Well, it's not actually a Christmas special, it's a New Year's Day special, which is a bit disappointing, really, but never mind. So he is back. I'm guessing this guy next to him is some kind of scientist. So are they working with the Daleks? And here is a Dalek. Yes, it is blue and black, even though you can't quite tell it is blue and black. I know Chris Chibnall said that there are some red ones. So that, could it be a Supreme Dalek? I know the last black Dalek we saw was a Dalek Sec. And here she is, the Doctor, in her prison clothes. Now, this actually, there's like lines, and she walks in. So is she walking into her cell, or is she walking into like a courtroom or something? You know, I don't really know. It could be interesting to find out, because she's confused, and there is a scene where there's like chalk marks on the wall and she's counting down the days. So how long has she been there? You know, is it years, months? And here is that picture I was talking about. So, judging by all of that on the wall, has she been there for years and the other guys not known, or months, or what? You know, and she says, hang on in there, because there are people out there. Like, judging by, because Jack's back in it, judging by because Jack's in it, could he try and find something? Or it'd be interesting to see how she actually gets out. Is the Doctor going to do a prison break? Now, this next one is Red Daleks. Now, are they red and black? They seem to be blasting their way through the streets. So it'll be interesting. Are they red? They look red and black, but that could be because they're in the dark. But they look quite good. These Daleks really do look, these new ones look really, really good. But my question is, I was reading the Radio Times, which is already out. And in it, Chris Chibnall has said that these are not the episode is connected to the other Dalek episode. And here is the Prime Minister and two Daleks. So, but she called them drones, air drones or something like that. So they'll be scanning the skies and stuff like that. But Chris Chibnall said that this episode and the other Dalek episode are slightly connected. So could that Dalek, that lone Dalek, that one Dalek that built itself, built these ones as well? Because if he had, and got in contact with that American guy, and go, oh, look, we'll help you, and then basically, you know what Daleks like, they want to take over the universe. Could that lead to thousands of deaths? And basically, it seems going to be interesting. I know Chris Chibnall, he never really reveals a lot, you know? So I'd be interested to find out. And this, I'm guessing, is when they open the... there's the Prime Minister on the left, the American guy in the middle. And I'm guessing that's a scientist. I'm guessing what they've done is they've opened the little hatch bit on the front of the Dalek to have a look inside. So could a mutant escape? Because there is another scene in the trailer of, I think it's Yaz, and the Dalek mutant hatches onto her back. So what does that mean? You know, have they unleashed something? Be interesting to see. It's all interesting. There's not much given away at the moment. There never is. Now this is another scene. This looks like single cell. So, for the doctor being, I think this is in the prison. But when you actually look, some of them, you can see some of the monsters. And on the left hand side, it looks like there's a Cyberman in a cell. Not entirely sure what the big thing is, but it looks like a Cyberman in a cell. And then the thing in the middle looks like it's got red coat, so that could be the doctor. But it's just a cell, either like a playground that you get in prison, they can walk about, or, you know, it's basically the Jadoon arrested these aliens. Or could it be an execution place? Could they be executing prisoners? Or could it be, I don't know, a visiting place where they visit, where people visit them? I literally don't know. This next one is Yaz. The reason I picked this picture out is because in the background of it are the round things. So I'm guessing this is in the TARDIS they got in the end of The Timeless Child. You know, they came back in a TARDIS, didn't they? Which would explain another image. Maybe they're trying to find the doctor out. You know, trying to find her, trying to... Where is she? Where could she have gone, you know? But that's Yaz. This is another Dalek. The reason I chose this is because you can actually see the silver bits and the black bits. And the goon and the sucker are different as well on them, which is interesting. But Chris Chibnall said they're not replacing, they're like a new type of Dalek, but they're not replacing the old Daleks. They never would replace the old Daleks, but they're like a new generation of Daleks, let's say that. A new generation of Daleks. Yeah, because it's quite interesting when you see how the Daleks have evolved over time. This is the image I was saying. Look at this. This is the inside of a TARDIS. Now, this is a classic TARDIS. By the console and all the walls. But also on the... There is post-it notes. And this is... I'm guessing this is Yaz, Ryan and... Graham. It has been confirmed now that Graham and Ryan are leaving. So what could happen to them, I don't know. But it has also been confirmed that Graham might make an appearance in series 13. Now this next episode I kept till last, mainly because look who it is. Yes, it is Captain Jack Harkness. Of course, that's what he says in the trailer. He's talking about... he talks about the Doctor at the beginning. About she either leaves you or you leave her, sort of thing. And then he says, I'm Captain Jack Harkness. I'm immortal. But That does make me wonder if they're going to do some kind of experiment on him. Are they going to kill Jack off? That is the question. Maybe they won't kill Jack off, because he's immortal, but it'll be interesting to see how and what he's doing in that episode. Anyway, so this is when it is on. It's on New Year's Day. I would like it on Christmas, because I miss having Doctor Who on at Christmas. I really, really do. But these red things on the side of this, they remind me of John Pertwee's title sequence for some reason. I don't know why, they just do. But so it's New Year's Day again, which kind of works out, because you can have a New Year's Day episode and then, what, autumn time you'll have the new series. Just, you know, a theory. And then if they do keep doing that, that would lead up to the 60th. You know, it'd lead up to the 60th. But it'd be interesting to see what Chris Chibnall does with that 60th. And of course, this series 13 is Jodie Whittaker's... Is it Jodie Whittaker's third series? Now, normally after three series, they leave. Be interesting if she stays on to do a fourth, so it is interesting. So here is a question. If, let's say, she does say bye-bye to the Doctor, what would you want? Would you want another female Doctor? Or would you want a male Doctor? Now, personally, after having a female Doctor, I'm not really that bothered. I'm really not that bothered. I'm not fussed. The Doctor is the Doctor. I don't see it as a he, she, or an it. He's just the Doctor. Anyway, I'm going to stop talking now, because this is going on way too much than I thought it would. But I have a little announcement. I have an Instagram account now where I will be doing competitions, Q&A, and doing exclusive bits of information. The link for it is in the description box below. It is HJP_designs. And if you follow me, you will stay up to date with when my videos come out, when Q&As are, because I will be doing some competitions. I'm definitely doing a competition. I think it'll probably be in the new year, probably New Year's Day. I haven't decided yet. And you will win some Doctor Who goodies, so I can share them on those. So get onto Instagram, follow me, and I will follow you back. Yes. Maybe. So go onto Instagram, follow me, and stay up with the latest news, because there'll be exclusive stuff. There'll be exclusive stuff on there which won't be on my YouTube channel, so keep your eyes peeled for them. So, all I've got to say now, well, you know what I'm going to say, is click subscribe, comment down below, and give this video a like and share it in case people have not seen this new trailer. And I will see you next time with another video. So,